Ben Sadler here, one of the pastors at Victory of the Lamb, and we're doing this three-part series on how to read the Bible. In the first video, I showed what is the Bible. In the last video, I showed how do you read, or what's the main storyline of the Bible. And now in this last video, I want to talk about how do you actually read the Bible. And I want to kind of model for you what I do, try to do every day when I wake up and open up my Bible. And so, in this video, I'll show you that. But first of all, I want us to kind of learn a little bit about reading the Bible by reading Psalm 1. So let me read to you Psalm 1. It says this: "Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the really teaching of the Lord, who meditates on that teaching day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers." And so what the writer here is saying is when you meditate on God's word every day, you become like a tree. And that means a lot, especially where this was written in the desert. A tree that's not waiting for water from the sky, but a tree that's fed by the river. And as you read God's word, you're fed by the water of life. So I just want to encourage you to take up this habit of reading every day. Well, how do you do this? What does this look like? So this is kind of what I do, and maybe you need to change this and make this work for yourself. But every day I start out by, first of all, quieting myself, finding a place where I can get away. I have a little office off our kitchen, and I try to get up before everybody else so I can have some time to just be alone. And I like to start off by reciting Psalm 143, verse 8. It goes like this: "Let the morning bring word of your unfailing love, for I put my trust in you. Show me the way I should go, for to you I entrust my life." I say that every morning. I'm just saying, let this morning, right now, help me remember God's unfailing love. God, remind me how much you love me, and now show me the way you want me to go as I read your word. Then I like to say the Lord's Prayer. The Lord's Prayer is kind of like this nice outline of reminding that God is my Father, and so I talk to him as my Father, and that I want his will to be done in my life. I want his kingdom to rule in my heart. I want to remember that my daily bread, he's going to give that to me today. I want to remember to be forgive other people. Also, to not be led into temptation. So it's a good way to kind of an outline of how to pray. And then I get into God's word, and I try to read a couple pages each day. And so, for example, I'll just open up and read, just like I got done reading. But reading in a way, literally the word meditate in that verse that I read you from Psalm 1 actually means to chew on something, to gnaw on something. And so when you read the Bible, if you remember in our first video, we talked about the Holy Spirit is behind this. And so God is speaking. The Master is talking to me. And so I want to read God's word with a sense of reverence and awe and expect that he's going to talk to me and expect that this is deeper than what I first heard. So that's one other thing, is when I read, I want to slow down and I want to meditate on what I'm actually reading. So maybe just going back to that Psalm 1 again and think about that. How would I read that and what would that look like? I would start by saying, okay, God, blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the teaching of the Lord, who meditates on it day and night. Okay, God, so I'm going to pray through this. Help me not to walk with the wicked or to follow their ways, but now, Lord God, help me to delight in your word. So I'm praying through this. I'm thinking about it and asking myself questions and asking God to open up. And so it's kind of this conversation between me and God. And then maybe to end it off, I have a journal, and sometimes I'll journal in there and maybe some insights that I got, and that will lead me to pray about the people that are on my mind. So however you do it, just remember that this is meditative literature. That means You want to read this every day. You might read through the Bible in a year or a couple of years, and then you're going to go over it again. And every time you read the Bible, you're going to find something new. And it's going to be different every time you read it. It's a lifelong journey, something to meditate on the rest of your life.